Hi folks, it's a real honour and privilege for me to be the first person, aside from the inventor, Eric Leckholm, to demonstrate his all-new MIDI harmonica, the DM48. It's a really amazing instrument. I've got absolutely no reeds, just uses breath sensors. It's a wind synthesizer basically, but it's all based on the form of a 12-hole chromatic harmonica. So anyway, I'd like to just explain a few of the little things that I've found in this amazing instrument in the last month or so, just while I've been getting to know it. Well, as I said, it's got no reeds inside. It's just got breath sensors, but there's a whole bunch of menus just on here, which allow you to set the expression, so you can make the thing respond pretty much how you are used to on a normal chromatic harmonica. So you can hear that the note can start very quiet and then swell just based on your breath. You can get good dynamics. It's got bending expression as well, which is just through increasing your breath pressure. And also you can make the bend go up if you want, just by pressing this little button here. So that's pretty cool. And you can dial in how much bend you want and how much breath pressure it takes to get the bend. What else have we got here? Okay, well, there's a tuning editor on board, believe it or not. And you can actually dial in what tuning you want. At the moment, I've got one of my own tunings in there, slide diatonic tuning. So it's kind of for Irish music. And it gives me all the slide decorations that I want, which is, in this case, normally a tone up. So it's for Irish music, that suits better. But if you're just playing standard chromatic, you just choose the tuning that you would normally use, which would probably be solo. So I'll just find that. And there we are, we're back to solo tuning. So at the moment it's in G solo. I don't know if you can see that, it's basically transposed down 5 semitones. But if I want to bring it back up to C, which is where it would normally be, you just press this little button, go into the menu, and it should now be back in C. If you want C sharp, you just go like that. Back to C. So basically you can change key just with the press of a button. So now it's operating totally as a normal 3-octave solo-tuned chromatic in the key of C. And the slider, it always goes up to the next note, the semitone up. But if you want to take that sound and go down an octave, you've got octave transpose, or you can go up an octave. So again, it's another menu, just hit the little button, and let's take it down an octave. Maybe down another one. So you've kind of got a bass harmonica in here as well as just a normal harmonica. We can even go lower if we want to. Even lower. Okay, you probably wouldn't want to go, we'll go lower than that, but you probably wouldn't want to go much lower than that. So we're now back to, okay, back up to the key of C. And of course it'll go up as well, if you want. Okay, so you can sound like a bass, or you can sound like a sort of a flageolet if you want. Another cool feature is the slider delay. Now, the slider has got a very short travel, and it takes a little bit of getting used to. It's actually pretty cool once you get used to it, but of course most of us coming from chromatic harmonicas are used to 4 or maybe 6 millimeter slide travel, so going down to 1 millimeter is a bit of an adjustment. And I found that the slider was too accurate for my finger. I think, you know, when we play normal chromatic harmonicas, because there's a bit of a lag in the time it takes for the slide to come back, our bodies have adjusted to anticipating that lag, and so we take our fingers off earlier than, you know, the note actually sounds in order to match up with the mechanical delay that's in our chromatics. Of course, we don't realize that's happening. That when I got this one here from Eric, basically I found that as soon as I pulled my finger off, the note was stopping and I couldn't play a chromatic scale. It sounded like this. I couldn't really get a clean chromatic scale. So he just made a menu called Slider Delay. And if you bring that up a bit. So now the slider operates more with the kind of delay that we have in our normal chromatics. And you can adjust that to whatever suits you. Slider interval. Now, as I said, slider interval is normally a semitone up. But if you want to, want to play Irish music and you want to go semitone down, so basically you can go down a semitone or you can go down a tone. And if you want to go up, you can. Here's the normal. So you can have all your sliders going up, three semitones if you want, or five semitones. But of course, one of probably the most famous aspect of MIDI is that you can sound like any instrument you want to. Basically, I've got a bunch of maybe 15 wind synthesizer patches here that Eric's sent me to try. So this one here is called Harmonity. But I'll just flick through and play you a few others. This is called Big Octaves. Bass clarinet. This is called Harmon lead. This is just trumpet. This is power chord. This is called pift. This is quite a nice one, Japanese flute. All of these sounds have got a lot of reverb, but it just takes a bit of time to reduce the reverb or whatever. But this is only a tiny selection of the sounds. With MIDI, of course, there's thousands and thousands, and you can sound like a guitar or a piano or whatever if you want to. Now you can play chords. If you wanted to, you could actually configure this as a chord harmonica. I haven't done that yet, but you could actually go through the tuning editor and turn it into a chord harmonica if you wanted to. And of course, you're not restricted to having high notes at one end and low notes at the other. You can have all the correct range of notes, even on hole number 12. You can have something that's down the same, you know, the same as hole number 1, so that you get nice your chords are in a nice range. So there's a huge potential there to make it into a chord harmonica as well as a bass harmonica, as well as everything else. One of the things that I like is that I can get up at 3 in the morning and practice on this with headphones on and no one can hear anything. You know, so you can basically, if you want to practice anywhere, anytime, you can get your DM48 and you won't be annoying anybody. That's pretty cool. And another really cool feature is that you can record your songs as MIDI files. And of course, MIDI files have got all the notes written down, the actual score. So if I was to play a little snatch of a tune. Okay, that would come out. have as a MIDI file with all the notes. Then I can go there and play it, give it to someone else. They can read it and they've got the notes there. So there's no need to go and write things down separately on bits of paper or on your computer. You just have to play it on here and it comes out as notes, which is pretty cool. So there's just so many amazing things. I mean, I'm an analog kind of guy. I've never played a MIDI instrument before, but suddenly I can use my harmonica technique that I've learned over many years and transfer it to this amazing instrument and get all sorts of incredible extra new sounds, new functionality that was just not possible on a standard harmonica. So that's just my little take on it. My friend Alan Glasser came down yesterday and had a little noodle on this thing, and suddenly he was putting out all this kind of jazz stuff. Here's a little of Adam playing the DM48, playing some jazz music on it. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, yeah,
that sounds
it's,
good.
It's actually, it's huge potential.
Yeah,
it's fun. Yeah. Mm.
So that's a little snapshot of the amazing new DM48, invented by Eric Lekholm from Sweden.